Okay, we'll call the July 15th Planning Commission to order with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey, we'll begin with roll call.
Mr. Bentley?
Here.
Mayor Drucker?
Here.
Mr. Mazur?
Here.
Mr. Newberry?
Here.
Mr. Palunas?
Here. Changes to the agenda. There are two changes to the agenda. If you look at item number 10, the third bullet point, instead of maximum, it should be minimum. And on item number 11, the third bullet point, instead of maximum, it should be minimum with regard to the variances that are described. Those are the changes to the agenda. And we will now go to comments from the audience regarding agenda items. If you have comments regarding any agenda item, please come forward. If you're a party to agenda item, you can discuss your agenda item when it comes up. Any comments? Seeing none, we have one set of minutes from June the 24th, 2014.
Move approved.
Second.
Move seconded. Thank you. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes. Moving on to pending, we have item number 135310 Solon Road, permanent parcel number 952-29012, the Dorothy S. May Revocable Trust. And this was before us quite a few times, and now we received an email from the applicant requesting that this be withdrawn.
I'd like to make a motion to withdraw the item 35312 Solon Road, please.
I'll second.
Second. Any further discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes. Moving on to item number 233755 Country View Lane, Lisa Harry. This was tabled at our meeting on the 10th of June, and on the 24th of June, it was also tabled. There's no new material, and we do not yet have any correspondence from the applicant.
Move to table.
Second.
Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes. Moving on to item number 3, we have 34182 Aurora Road, Echo Solon LLC. Paul Cola is here this evening. This is a site plan for restriping. We did have this discussed at our Safety and Public Properties Committee, and we are not going to be doing anything with this plan pending the application and the full discussion at Safety and Public Properties of the safety ramifications of the bank. But Mr. Cole, if you'd like to come up and address the committee at all, you're welcome to address us. And then we're not going to take any action on this tonight, but after the other plan goes through and your engineers meet with the engineers from the bank, then we can go forward. The reason we're not going forward, so the public's knowledge tonight, is because my personal position is that I did not want to make and the applicant go forward with a plan, then have to pull out the plan because of the fact that the bank is coming in. You'd have to expend all that money for maybe only a few months, and I just didn't think it made sense from a business perspective for you and for the city to order you to do something that you'd have to take out eventually. So I don't think it's a good use of anyone's time or money. But Mr. Cola, please identify yourself.
Paul Cola, representing Echo Solon LLC. Greatly appreciated, and we just wanted to make everyone aware that we were willing to do this with the understanding that we might have to change it down the road, just mainly because of the safety concerns that have been brought to our attention. So we respect your decision and just to wait on what happens with the bank parcel.
Okay, thank you. Are there any questions for Ms. Cola?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Have a great night.
You too. Bye-bye.
Move on to item number 457.
I thought we were going to move that.
Do we want to table this?
I thought we were going to move to inactive. Caucus, when you talked about
Move to inactive.
Yeah, move it to item number 3.
I didn't know if we needed action on that.
You going to make a motion?
I did.
Oh, I'll second.
Moved and seconded.
Okay, who made the motion?
Roger made the motion. Bill seconded.
Okay. Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes. Moving on to item number 45750 Harper Road, Nestle Prepared Foods. We tabled this at our meeting on the 24th. We have no new material, and Nestle is asking that we table this again this evening.
Move to table.
I'll second.
Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Plunis?
Yes. Moving on to item number five on our new agenda, 6931 Highland Drive, Kristen Brown, permanent parcel numbers 955-33088, 955-33089, 955-33090, 955-33119, 955-33120, 955-33121. This is in Ward 3. It's a lot consolidation, and we need to schedule a public hearing.
I'll make a motion to schedule a public hearing for our next meeting.
Second.
Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Plunis?
Yes. Moving on to item number six, 30500 Carter Street, Pat Christopher, Davis Construction Management. Evening, Al. How are you?
I'm well.
Please state your name for the record.
Al Wang and I am Davis Development Group, 32,000 Solon Road, Solon, Ohio. What we have tonight is a plan to add 20,000 square feet to the existing Christopher Tool building on 30500 Carter Street. We originally built the building back in 1970, put an addition on in 79, and now they've come back and asked us to complete a new addition for them. There we go. Essentially, what we're doing is just adding 20,000 square feet to the back of the building. The existing building, it's pretty simple building. Existing building is brick. The back of the building, the far wall of the building is a painted block towards the back. The brick that's going to be used to match the second brick that was put on the second edition is the Hershey Blend Extruded Series. It's a wire-cut brick. And then the metal panel that's on the building now is a Centria Aspen Gold, which we were able to match up. And we have one variance. We have a parking lot with one access point onto Carter Street, which when the building was built was perfectly fine. And the addition was built was perfectly fine. Now, any more than 25 cars, we have to have two access. And we're asking for a variance on that.
Any questions for Mr. Wagenheim?
Just a note for the record, the fire inspector did say it was okay, did put a stamp of approval on the single drive.
Yes.
Okay, any other questions? Hearing none, I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make a motion to approve a single street access drive waiver for 30500 Carter Street.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any further discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Plunis?
Yes.
I make a motion for a revised site plan for the addition and parking lot expansion with the contingency that the applicant file a lot split and a lot consolidation plat prior to receiving a certificate of occupancy.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Thank you. Discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Plunis?
Yes. You're going to be at our next council meeting, which is going to be on the 21st of July, and the caucus, you know.
I will not be here, but somebody will be represented. The architect will be here for that meeting.
Okay, as long as you can have a representative here. It may be on the consent agenda, so they might not have to stay for the entire meeting.
Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good evening.
Thank you. You too.
Moving on to item number seven. 37045 Halton Court, Emil and Victoria Hayek. Good evening, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. Can you please state your name for the record?
Victoria Hayek.
And you're a property owner?
Yes.
Okay.
We have a variance for a pool equipment room.
Okay, if you could show where the home is and where the pool is going to be.
The home is here.
Okay.
And the equipment room is going to be here. on the 15-foot setback.
The equipment room's going to be a 15-foot setback, and how big is that room going to be?
It is going to be... 168 square feet.
Anyone have any questions on this?
Is there a structure in the location where the pool house is going to be now?
No.
Okay.
No, we spoke with the adjacent neighbors, and it wouldn't interfere with their property.
Right. Okay, it looks from the GIS image that I looked at, that like there's a clear space or something back in that corner where the pool building's going to go.
There's nothing, we had some landscaping around it.
Okay.
On here, and that's all that's back there.
Okay.
I live around the corner from you, so I'm pretty familiar with what's going on over here, and...
So you're going to vote against it?
Of course. So the neighbors just did the same kind of thing a little while ago, so I think that was a precedent for it to go ahead, and I'd like to make a motion for 37045 Halton Court for a 24-square-foot pool building area variance, please.
Second.
Moved and seconded, thank you. Any further discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
I'll move to approve a 21-foot maximum pool building setback variance.
I'll second that.
Moved and seconded, further discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes. Okay, your item has been passed tonight. It will be at City Council on the 21st of July.
Okay.
And that'll be at 7:00 p.m. in the caucus room, which is a room that we had our caucus this evening. And you'll want to come to the caucus because this may be on the consent agenda. If it is on the consent agenda, the vice mayor will inform you, and you won't have to stay for the entire meeting.
Okay, all right, thank you.
Thank you, have a good evening.
You too.
Moving on to item number eight, we have 34171 Russell Drive, David and Louise Soltis. Permanent parcel numbers 956-09024, 956-09025, lot consolidation, and we need a public hearing scheduled.
I'll move to schedule a public hearing at our next meeting.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes. Is the applicant here? Oh, okay. This will be set at our next Planning Commission meeting, which is July 29th, and the caucus will be again in that room, in the same room we were at in the caucus room. And the meeting will be in this room, starting at 7:30, and we will have a public hearing, and we will most likely take action after the public hearing. So if you can be at the next meeting, we appreciate you coming tonight also. If you have any questions in the meantime, you can contact the Planning Department, Mr. Franklin's office. They'll be happy to help you. Have a good evening. Moving on to 30800 Miles Road, Syed Rahman. Permanent parcel numbers 95142037, 95142038. We have a lot consolidation.
Move to schedule a public hearing at our next meeting.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes. Is the applicant here on that item? Okay. If you could please send, if the clerk could send a notice to the applicant that they need to be at the next meeting. Moving on to item number 10, 35800 Solon Road, Gerald Praisner. We have a maximum decorative wall height variance on the Solon Road west wall, 0.3-inch variance. On the Solon Road east wall, 0.03-inch variance. Pepper Drive north wall, 0.03-inch variance. Pepper Drive south wall, 0.03-inch variance.
Feet.
Or feet, foot, I'm sorry, foot. Point 0.3 foot. Do we want to take all of them at one time, or do you want to go section by section?
I think we do them all at one time. They're all the same.
Maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance, Solon Road west wall, 38-foot variance. Solon Road east wall, 42-foot variance. Pepper Drive north wall, 35-foot variance. Pepper Drive south wall, 35-foot variance. minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variances. Solon Road West Wall, 30-foot variance. Solon Road East Wall, 30-foot variance. Pepper Drive North Wall, 30-foot variance. Pepper Drive South Wall, 30-foot variance.
Good job.
Boy, you're making us work tonight.
All right.
Please state your name and your address.
Gerald Preisner, 35800 Solon Road, Solon, Ohio.
How are you this evening?
I'm great. How are you?
Good, thank you. Now that I'm done with that, good.
Okay.
If you want to go through and tell us exactly what the variances are.
Well, I'm just looking to put decorative columns on each side of my driveway. Nothing really elaborate. 2x2 in width. And I believe I wanted to be at the city's, I think it was 36 inches height. I'm okay with that. I don't know where the 0.3 came in. But I'm okay with the height. It's 36 inches, correct?
Right.
You would simply withdraw the variance if you didn't need that variance.
Would it have maybe been the...
It might be the cap. It's the cap. That's what it is.
Then, then that's what you're... So if you want the cap, then you're going to still need that variance.
Yes, then if you can leave it, then that'd be fine.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure it's going to be hotly contested with the 0.3. Okay. If you want to keep going.
Yes. That's all I have to say. Just decorative, make my yard look nice.
And the brick you're going to use?
It's going to be the same brick that's on the house. I managed to save it 18 years.
You saved the same brick for
18 years? I did. For this day.
Wow.
My wife wants it gone, so I have to use it.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
I'm having a little difficulty with this application, especially for the height. I'm trying to figure out what the practical difficulty or the hardship is by having the walls be 40 inches tall versus 36, which would be permitted by the code. To me, it's one or two courses of brick, and you can still have the cap. Visually, it wouldn't make that much difference.
Well, I'm fine with 36 then.
I'll move to accept withdrawal of the wall height variances.
Second. If that's okay with you.
That's fine with me.
I want you to use up all that brick, though, so it's
I think
make your wife happy.
I know. I think I have just enough.
And I was going to have to build something
it's
else.
He's going to have to save it for another project.
No.
We'll be back here. Do we have a motion and a second?
Stool in front of the hearth.
Are there any further discussion on the motion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes. Moving on to the next variance.
If there's nothing else, I'll start off with... I'll move to approve the maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance for the Solon Road West Wall at 38 feet of the variance.
I'll second.
Okay. Discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I'll make a motion for a maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance for the Solon Road East Wall at 42 feet.
Second.
Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I'll make the motion then for the maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance for the Pepper Drive North Wall at 35 feet variance.
Second.
Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion for the maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance for the Pepper Drive South Wall at a 35-foot variance, please.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I'll move to approve a minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variance for the Solon Road West Wall at 30 feet.
Second.
Discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I make a motion to approve a minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variance for the Solon Road East Wall at 30 feet of variance.
Second.
Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Then I get to make the motion for a minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variance of 30 feet for the Pepper Drive North Wall.
Second.
Second. Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion for the minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variance for the Pepper Drive south wall at 30 feet, please.
Second.
Second, thank you. Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes. Okay. I think we're good. And I will see you, and we will see you at the council meeting July 21st, 2014. It'll be in the caucus room. And again, you will...
29th.
That's a commission meeting. Council. Council.
Sorry.
For the record, I had it correct.
Okay.
Just highly unusual.
It's the first time. Usually Carol has everything correct.
Carol's off tonight.
This is the first time in, I think, 13 years that Carol has been wrong.
No, maybe one other time.
Maybe one other time. But it'll be on the July 21st in the caucus room. And you might be on the consent agenda. If you're on the consent agenda, you will not have to stay for the meeting. The vice mayor will instruct you whether you need to stay for the meeting. Most likely, you will not need to.
Very good. Thank you.
Thank you. Have a good night.
You too. Thanks.
Okay, we're moving on to item number 11, 33800 Miles Road, Aaron and Elaine Salomon. We have 6.5-foot maximum decorative wall height variances. We have maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variances, the middle west wall, 37-foot variance, middle east wall, 37-foot variance, entry west wall, 95-foot variance, entry east wall, 95-foot variance, minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variances, entry west wall, 28-foot variance, entry east wall, 28-foot variance. Is the applicant here? Please state your name and your address.
My name is Aaron Salomon, 33800 Miles Road.
Okay, it's my understanding these pillars are that you've already installed, so they're already represented on the pictures that you're going to show?
Yes, they are. I installed the pillars. I didn't know that we needed anything because they were shorter, I think. It's not, and they're also built on gravel, not cemented in the ground. So we've done a number of different projects around our house that we've had to get variances for and approval for, and it was my understanding that if it was permanent, cemented in, whatever happened to me, that we'd have to do it. So we put them in, and they're in. So I took pictures of from different angles. This one here happens to be from the house. This one here happens to be from the street, as these are as well.
If we can zoom in on the ones from the street and the house, both of them, so we can see. Okay. So the commission and the public can see what we're...
I can move these. Actually, I can move them around to make it a little easier.
If you could move them closer to the square.
Square? Okay.
And then we can zoom in on those.
Hope that's easier. I hope.
Yeah. He can pan and tilt it a little bit, too.
Okay. So today I took pictures from, this one happens to be from the other side of the street. This one happens to be kind of pulling into the driveway where my mailbox is at. This happens to be on the other side of the driveway here too. So one of the setbacks or the variances we need is, I guess these pillars up here are too close. And then the middle ones, which are in this picture, I guess they have to be 30 feet from the house. My driveway is 150 feet long. So we evenly space them 53 feet from one another, and the ones closest to the house, which are these right here, are, I think, are 13 feet. So that's what we did. And then I took closer ups of the actual pillar itself. They're all the same.
In your letter, you stated you've done a number of projects before that have needed variances or approval, and you've always gotten the approvals before you went forward. You just didn't know, correct?
Yeah. I would never put them in if I knew that we would have to do this. So.
Any questions from the commission?
Mr. Chairman, I have no problem with what you did. Only the fact of the timing that you didn't ask for get the permits. But just so you know, I will vote in favor of these, but there will be a penalty. So, possibly signed by the building department, building commissioner. Okay.
In the aerial photographs we're looking at, it looks like, is your driveway concrete? Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, because in the aerial photograph, it doesn't look like it is. Maybe it's an older photograph, something like that. Because the pad around the house absolutely looks like it's brand new concrete in the aerial photograph. But
we did the driveway last spring.
Okay, so that's what it is. Okay.
Yeah. So.
Okay. I again concur with my colleague that. I think it looks nice. It's a nice job, and I guess my only other concern would be, since he didn't put them on concrete footers, 30, 42 inches down, is that gonna fall over and sink one day? Roger, what do you think?
But that's his risk at this point. Yeah. Mr. Chairman, I have the same objection to the maximum decorative wall height variances. As I expressed previously, I don't see that there's any practical difficulty other than the walls are already there, which leads me to another objection. I am not in the habit of granting forgiveness for zoning violations. It's very distasteful to me to have to do that, or have this commission have to do that, and have our residences essentially bypass the rules in order to get something done, and then come and say, oh, geez, I'm sorry, I didn't know. That's all.
Mayor?
The way I look at it when somebody does some work is, would I have approved it beforehand had you come earlier? And I would have. So I am going to approve it. And as with the last applicant, I would have approved the cap. So I'm going to support these variances. So.
Anyone else? I think you did a great job here. I think it looks really nice. It looks really good. I looked at it, drove by there, and I think you did good work. And I have no objection to the work that you did or the any of the variances. So I'm fine with going forward with what you did. I understand with your letter you have, and I know you've gotten city approval for everything else. I understand it was a reasonable mistake. So
yeah, I would have never done it if I didn't know. If I knew.
I understand. I have no problem with it, so I'll entertain a motion.
I will, with the six decorative height variances, do we do those all at once? That could all be one?
They're published separately, so I prefer if you address them.
There's six half-foot.
There's six.
On the first
one. Oh, I'm sorry.
Maximum,
look at that.
So
okay.
I can read it as one motion,
yes,
right?
Yes.
Okay. I will move to approve six half-foot maximum decorative wall height variances for 33800 Miles Road.
I will second.
Okay, discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
No.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
I will make a motion for approval for a maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance for the middle west wall at 37 feet.
Second.
Discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
No.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion for the maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance for the middle east wall at 37 feet, please.
Second.
Discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
No.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
I'll move to approve a maximum decorative wall setback from dwelling variance for the entry west wall at 95 feet. For a 95-foot variance.
I will second.
Discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
No.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
I'll make a motion for a maximum decorative wall setback from variance from the from the dwelling for the east entry wall at 95 feet.
Second.
Discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
No.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
I'd like to make a minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variance for the entry west wall at 28 feet, please.
Second.
Discussion. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
No.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
And I'll move for approval of a minimum decorative wall setback from right-of-way variance for the entry east wall at, for a 28-foot variance.
I will second.
Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
No.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes. Okay, this will be at our next council meeting, which will be on the 21st of July. And as I told the other applicants, you can come for the caucus, and you most likely will be on the consent agenda. And if you are on the consent agenda, the vice mayor will instruct you, and you will not have to stay for the meeting.
Okay.
So that'll be the 21st of July.
And that's 7 o'clock as well?
Correct.
All right.
And that'll be in the caucus room where we had our caucus this evening.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for coming. Have a good evening.
Thank you, too.
Moving on to item number 12, 32910 Solon Road. Solon Road Enterprises, Jim Aleshi, equipment screening variance. Good evening, Frank. How are you?
Well, how are you?
Good. Please state your name and address.
Frank Aleshi, 32910 Solon Road.
And Mr. Aleshi, you have an ongoing project there?
Yep.
And what is the issue with the project?
Well, we'd like to maybe save a few dollars, and the equipment on the roof is brand new. Looks pretty nice. Potentially withdraw the screening that we had planned on originally.
Frank, you want to put this in the yellow just so everybody in the audience can see.
Okay, if you could just orient us to the for the people who don't have the photo in front of them, just tell them where the where the equipment is placed.
You'll see a number of brand new units here, 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 and here. There's two units, one of which sits directly in front of the one that I'm pointing to now. One here and here that have recently been removed since this picture's been taken.
So which units are existing now?
This small cat near the whatever this antenna, this tower. Okay, there's so one behind this old unit. Here near this tree, here and here. There's also one older piece, but that's towards the backhand corner.
So the two you initially pointed out near the tower are bordering the police department parking
correct.
Lot and the
correct.
Liberty Ford parking lot. Would that be correct?
Correct.
And the next
most of the units border the back end of the building, which faces Liberty Ford.
And the next photo that we have is a photo of the recommended screening for those items. Is that
actually, this one shows the ones that have been removed. If you could see, here's the new ones, and here are the old ones.
Okay, oh, I was referring. Okay,
yeah. Just so,
I was referring
just
to
clear.
That. This is what I was. This is the recommended screening, correct?
Yes.
And if you can go back to the, if you can go back to the second photo with just the new items, the lower one. There you go, right there. We could zoom in a little bit, please. Slide a little bit to your right. Thank you. Okay. The requirement is that those be screened, and I believe there's also a recommendation that it could be painted, an alternative to screening, or we could do nothing, I believe. Those are the three alternatives. So,
yeah, I took a little drive over there a couple days ago and took a look, Frank, and they I drove into the parking lot across the street from you. I believe it's a real estate agent office across the street. And the elevation from there, it's quite a bit higher than the street where you took the photos or whoever took these photos. And they are pretty visible from there. I also drove into the daycare center, and they're fairly visible from that side, too. But I'm really not in favor of that the screening that was suggested, the picket fence thing. So I would, if I, if it's not too much trouble, I understand, you know, you guys are making a big investment over there, and I can't wait for, I keep driving by waiting for the store to open. I really can't wait for it to open. I love them where it is now, but I can't wait for the new one. But if we could paint it the same color, I think that would probably be the best solution for everybody.
Of the building?
Yes.
Same color as the,
That we're going to stain the brick or the roof? The rooftop, the white?
Yeah.
This is a white trim. This is more of like a beige, I suppose.
I would like the beige.
I would recommend that we let the architect take a look at that. Let him pick the color. But I'm also in favor of allowing this to be painted. I think we had the same situation with Station 43 several years ago.
Yeah, with the Liberty Ford recently,
too. Yeah, and Liberty Ford, so, you know.
I think the issue with Station 43 is, first of all, I'm not in favor of putting the fencing around it. I think that's a huge cost burden for you, and I think that's a, it's going to make it look worse, in my opinion. Second, the Station 43, we had a big debate at council a number of years ago, I remember, with regard to the painting of the exhaust ducts. They were on the side of the building, and Station 43 is on Aurora Road, but it's right by residential. I mean, it borders on basically almost three sides by residential, and that was the reason that I voted in favor of the painting of that. I don't know necessarily if, and Liberty Ford was a little bit different situation too, but I definitely don't, I'm not in favor of the screening, the painting. I want to hear more from the rest of the commission and the planning department before I make a decision on that.
I would be in support of painting, but again, I would leave that the final decision of what color to the architect, because you do have the two, you have the trim color and then the building color, and I think what the architects paid to do, so.
But
I would, that I, just for picking the color.
Yeah, and I don't know necessarily if I want to find out if painting it's going to make it look worse than it would be in its natural state, because right now you have, and I'm not, Mackie, you might be a little bit better to ask than anyone else here, but you have a you have a tan color, it appears, and you have a white color on top, and then you have a stainless steel, and it appears the condenser units green, was it a greenish color?
Yeah,
I'd say it's gray green.
Grayish green color.
The greener side of gray.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it might stand out more if you paint it than it would now. I don't know. That's a question I have for you.
No, it would blend into the building. You know, to me, the beige or the white, I think Charlie could figure it out. Charlie would do it, right?
Make no, the architect.
Our architect would. Yeah.
Fred.
Okay,
probably Fred,
yeah.
Margulis.
And they, either the white or the beige, it would blend into the building. It would almost look like an extension of the building itself. So that would be, you know, that's what, and I'm fine with him making that decision. That's, you know,
now you got Mr. Mazur saying black and gold. No.
I don't know.
No Pittsburgh colors. No Steelers colors.
Question I have for you. Is this going to be a very big, I know the fencing would be a very big financial burden. Is this going to be a very big financial burden? I know you're putting a lot of money in the building.
And we'd be happy to paint it. We'd love to do nothing, but we're a lot happier to paint it than we are to put the screening up. The screening is a financial burden.
I think we all agree that fencing just wouldn't look right up there anyway.
The other question I have for, I don't know, maybe it's for Mr. Newberry, the paint, if you, when you paint it, does it actually, how long does the paint last before it needs to be repainted? Because I don't want to have them paint it, and then a year and a half from now, our zoning inspector is saying, well, the stainless steel will be fine for years. All of a sudden, the paint's coming off, and he gets a citation, and I don't want to have that happen either.
That's the difference between you and me, you or me painting it and a professional. The train units, which is the gray one, gray-green one that you see in the picture, the surface on those is meant to accept paint. So when you get a good quality paint, and you put a little charge to the unit to make the paint adhere, it'll stay down there for quite a while.
What's quite a while?
15, 20 years.
Okay. We can also make the condition that they have to maintain it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Something happened to it, they would have to touch up the paint.
You know, I just didn't want to have it happen where they're painting it, where it's like when you're painting a house or something.
Right. Yeah. Well, you know, and applied coating is, you know, if it's damp out or humid out, that's not the day to paint. A day like today would be perfect because it's not too warm, it's not too cold, there's not too much humidity in the air, so the paint will stick. Humidity.
Humility or humidity?
That's what I thought.
I'm glad you caught that.
I thought I heard that wrong, so I just let it go.
Yeah.
Mr. Chairman, to bring the painting discussion to an end, I will make a motion to approve equipment screening variance with the recommendation that it be painted based upon the recommendation of the city architect, and that, in fact, the equipment be maintained forever in a good condition.
I'll second the motion, although I'm not sure what the definition of forever is.
While the building stands.
Okay. Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Galunas?
Yes. Okay. Thank you. You're going to be on the council agenda for the 21st, and the caucus is going to be at 7 p.m., and it's going to be in the same room, and you've been there a number of times. And also, you most likely be on the consent agenda, so you'll be able to not have to stay for the entire meeting, but we like to have an audience sometimes, so.
I'll be there for you.
Usually, we don't have much of an audience.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
We appreciate it.
Okay, next item is item number 13, 30401 Wedgewood Drive, Ruth Wolfson. Number of accessory structure variance to permit 2. You please come up and to the microphone, please state your name and address. Good evening, how are you?
Hi. I'm Ruthie Wolfson, and I live at 30401 Wedgewood Drive in Solon. So, you want me to?
We have your letter.
Yeah.
And we have your letter, and we have what you would like to put in. And we have when the house was built in the 70s, and we have a copy of your plat, and we have a copy of the GIS, and we have a rendering of what you'd like to put in. So if you'd just like to show what you would like to put in and talk about the accessory that you currently have there.
Okay.
It appears you currently have one item in the yard.
Oh, so I have a shed.
Yes, okay.
Right.
And this would be a second structure in the yard. We deem these as structures in the city. So okay. You'd have this be a second. If you just want to show a rendering of what you want to put in.
Okay. So this is a picture of a pergola. It's movable. And it's a shade structure so that I can enjoy the outdoors in the front, which is large. It's expansive front yard, so it's would be nice to be able to enjoy the front yard. I took pictures of, I put landscaping in, I created a courtyard that this would, so I could show you the landscaping, and that it's not visible from the street. What I'm asking for. Would you like to see that?
Sure.
Okay. So this is a picture from the street at Wedgewood and Holly Hill, which is I'm on the corner lot. So that's the first angle. And that would be just a few steps west. I took pictures all the way across the front of the house. And so that's in front of the house from the street.
And put that picture, sure. Now where's the structure, where do you want to put the pergola?
It's behind this,
right in there,
these
okay.
Trees.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's moving towards the stage right of the lot, of the front of the house.
Still hidden behind that?
Correct.
Okay. Yeah.
And that's, once again, let's see, that's all the way to the corner of my lot, taking a picture of the front of the house. So all the way, standing at the corner of, you know, the line, the property line of my neighbor. I only have one neighbor because I'm on the corner. Who doesn't mind at all. And then this is a closer up picture of the planting. So that's
okay, Mayor.
Rob, I just have a quick question.
Sure.
Because this is you already have the patio, so you're actually putting the pergola on an existing patio.
Yeah.
So Rob, if that was connected to the house, she wouldn't even need a variance.
If it was a substantial connection, that's true.
So, I mean, and for what you're showing, I mean, I'm going to support this variance because just by connecting some, I remember years ago we had something similar.
Shimmets.
As a person actually connected it to the house, so then they didn't need the variance. But that might not work for your situation. I'm not saying to do that, but to me, the way it's all shaped, you have that courtyard and it does help with the shade.
Right.
I'm going to support that because I, even though I know we call that a structure, it's not as if you're asking for a second shed or what have you. So,
correct.
But I just wanted to clarify that if it was connected to the house, you wouldn't even need a variance. But so that's why I think it's, but I understand the need too. You want to enjoy your yard, but you need some shade. It's hard to sit in that direct sun. So,
right.
So I'm going to support the variance.
Thank you.
I have no issue with the variance. I see from your letter that your neighbors, you state that your neighbors don't have any complaints about it. The shrubbery looks beautiful.
Thank you.
And I think it's going to be a nice addition to your home. So I have no objection whatsoever to the variance.
Thank you.
Any other discussion?
Mr. Chairman, go ahead.
No, I don't have anything.
Okay. Mr. Chairman, I would be pleased to make a motion to approve a number of accessory structures variance to permit two for Ruth Wilson at 30401 Wedgewood Drive.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Thank you. Any discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palumbi?
Yes. Okay, you've passed the Planning Commission tonight. It will go to City Council on the 21st at 7 p.m. in the caucus.
Okay.
And the Vice Mayor will let you know. Most likely this will be on the consent agenda.
Okay.
If it's on the consent agenda, it'll pass automatically without you having to come and represent to Council.
Oh.
So they'll let you know, the Vice Mayor will let you know at the Council caucus whether or not you need to stay for the entire meeting.
Okay. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
It might not pass automatic.
It still is up to Council. It's not actually automatic, but usually it'll go through.
Yeah, usually it'll go through. Let's put that in the record. Most of the time.
You might end the tradition of consent agendas for the Planning Commission with that kind of comment.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
I've never seen one not, but.
There's always a first time.
Thank you. Have a good evening. Moving on to the next item, we have item number 1436720, Valley Forge Drive. And we have a 14-foot rear yard setback variance. Could you please state your name?
Yes, I'm Richard Sear and the owner of the said property.
Okay, and we have some photographs that you submitted, and we have a, Mr. Newberry, we do have a plat here.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, this is the plat. And it shows the location of a 14 by 20 foot deck that I want to replace an existing deck in this area of my home. And I've been informed that if it was just a replacement of the deck, that I really wouldn't need a variance because it would have been grandfathered because the previous deck was there for about 30 years. We've always wanted to enclose the deck with screening so that we could enjoy it as much as possible in the evenings without being worried about bugs and being outside. My wife has always wanted a screened-in porch. And there's no, my house is actually 40 feet from the property line. So any structure that I would have to put in there would require a variance. Now, this is the way my house looks right now because there's nothing there.
Wait a minute.
You could turn it around, please.
Turn it around.
Yeah, you built your house upside down.
Yeah, it looks like this now. So I want to put the deck in and screen it. And when I get done, I expect that it's going to look like this with the screen.
You could turn
porch.
Around, too.
Around again.
Thank you.
Yes, so you can see it. There you go.
Oh, okay,
I expect it to look like this. And with, of course, the required, the plans have already been submitted to the building department. We're going to have the required railings, required all the required materials as the building department wanted. So it's all been approved by them.
It's a attractive looking room.
Hmm. Well, I think if your wife wants a screened in porch, I think it's a smart thing. You get a screened in porch. If no one has any comments, then I'll move to approve a 14-foot rear yard setback variance for 36720 Valley Forge Drive.
I will second.
Discussion? Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes. Thank you, sir. You will be on the council agenda again for the 21st of July. That'll be at 7 p.m. in the caucus room. As I've told everyone else regarding the consent agenda, you heard it from everyone.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right, we'll move on to council referral. We have a public hearing set for the rezoning request for DJM Group for property located at the intersection of Aurora and Harper Roads. And we have a public hearing, so we'll open the public hearing. Anyone like to speak on this issue? Anyone like to speak on this issue? We will keep the public hearing open, and I'll entertain a motion to table.
I'll make a motion to table.
Second.
Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes. Moving on to minor alterations from the planning department.
I just had, so we're going to reopen the public hearing later then?
We're going to keep, we kept it open.
Just the item or the public hearing? That's why I just.
The public hearing can remain open.
We're going to continue, yeah.
I just wanted to make sure.
Yeah, we're going to continue until next month.
I don't know where my.
Or next meeting.
I just wanted to make sure, right.
Yeah.
Got it. Thank you.
Oh, no problem. Minor alterations from the planning department. Rob? Rob, we missed the days when you spoke a lot at the meetings.
Do some voice exercises here. Pretty simple. We just have one issue. This is Regal Cleaners. Basically, they were approved to move from this spot in Shops of Soma North on Miles and Brainerd Road to this spot. It went to Safety and Public Properties, and it was approved based upon, I think, no signage, and basically the drive-thru would stay the way that it is. When the plans came through, though there was actually a change, we just wanted to bring to your attention. Drive-through window here, as you were looking south on the property, was also a depository box for 24-hour depository on site. So I want to make sure that commission was okay with that alteration.
The only question I had, Rob, is there's not going to be any additional, as long as there's not any additional signage or any additional lights around it or anything like that?
No, just showing the box would be a two-by-two box.
Okay. Any objections?
I have a big note on it. It says night depository. But you can't see it because it's at night.
We talked about headlights shining, right? Could that be a concern to anyone on the commission?
I don't know. I don't know if it would be if it would affect any residents around there, because I think there's some fencing in back.
There's fencing and some landscaping.
For the residents on Brainerd Road, there's some I know there's some fencing there.
Big white fence.
There's some substantial screening, so I don't think it'll. I don't think it'll be a problem.
Perfect.
Next item, Rob?
That's it.
That's it. Okay. Comments from the commission, beginning with the mayor.
I have a few. First, of course, I want to remind everyone that we're going to be having our Home Days festival coming up, that we have a few changes, so I want to make sure we've been getting a few phone calls just to clarify a few things. Home Days is a three-day event this year, starting Friday, July 25th at 5 o'clock. The festival will begin, and that will run through Sunday, July 27th. Saturday is really the big day with the changes. We are going to start off with the Kiwanis breakfast on Saturday morning from 8 to 11. The community center will be open for the Kiwanis breakfast. Once the breakfast is over, the community center is closed. However, the restrooms will remain open because, of course, we're going to have the Rock and Roll Capital Street Machines with their car crews as part of Home Days on Ports Parkway and in the community park. Also, the parade is going to be held on Saturday this year, which is a lot different than previous years, which is usually on Sunday. And that's, of course, to accommodate the band, because everything's greater with the Solon High School band when they get to participate. So the parade will be Saturday at 1 o'clock. And it will follow the normal parade route. So so please look forward to seeing everybody, but just to take note of some of those changes. Secondly, we have another event. This one is on August 1st. This is called Cops on Top in Solon, Ohio. It will run from August 1st. It will run on August 1st and August 2nd. The 2014 Law Enforcement Torch Run for Special Olympics will partner with Walgreens of Solon and host our first ever Cop on Top event. The police will be ascending scaffolding on the corner of 91 and Bainbridge Road in front of Walgreens at 6 a.m. on Friday, August 1st. This is to raise money and awareness for the Ohio Special Olympics. Members of area police departments will occupy the scaffolding for 36 hours until 6 p.m. on August 2nd. Don't worry, Rob, they have all the permits and approvals that they need.
That's what I was thinking.
Please come out and support our police officers for this worthy cause. And then a final announcement. I am very proud to announce that this past Wednesday, the city of Solon, you know, as you know, Team NEO has their Plus Awards for Economic Development Excellence every year. And this year, the competition's hosted by Team NEO in partnership with Inside Business Magazine. And this year, there were 10 categories. And Solon, along with the Greater Cleveland Partnership, was the recipient of the Business Attraction Award that involves more than 100 employees. It was awarded jointly to the City of Solon and Greater Cleveland Partnership for our combined efforts in bringing the Nestle Pizza Division with 250 employees to the City of Solon. So congratulations to everybody involved. Another proud moment and another proud award for the city. So with that, thank you very much.
Thank you. Mackey?
No comments tonight.
Roger?
Just to steal Bill's thunder, the winning tickets are already in my notebook here, and his buddy Bielowski told me he was got the table leveled this year so he doesn't have to put my stubs underneath the leg.
Okay, I would just like to put a plug in for the Solon Benevolent Fund's raffle at Solon Home Days, which will be held on Sunday, the raffle on Sunday. The grand prize is $5,000 donated by Davis Automotive and Davis Development, two $500 gift certificates from Rusty Bucket, and two $500 gas cards from the Plumbing Source, and a 55-inch TV from Sam's Club. So, plus, as of 4 o'clock this afternoon, the Solon Benevolent Fund has accumulated an additional $10,000 worth of prizes from companies and retailers in Solon that will be awarded on half-hour increments. So buy your tickets early and buy them often. They're $5 a piece or 5 for 20. And just for the record, to let everyone know that this money stays in Solon, and the Solon Benevolent Fund has awarded over $180,000 to local Solon residents and churches and organizations. So please spend your money wisely and spend it at Solon Benevolent Fund. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, I've had a few comments from residents over the past week or so. The cameras that, just so everyone knows, we discussed this at our safety meeting, the cameras that are up are going up on the streetlights are not traffic cameras. So they're not traffic cameras. They are not for that purpose. We discussed it at our safety committee meeting, just so everyone knows who's watching tonight. I did receive another two or three calls today regarding that. So I'm sure the mayor's office has received calls. So, and I know many of the other council members have. That's why we addressed it at our safety committee meeting. So that's all I have. Rob?
No comments.
Vaughn?
No comments this evening.
Carol?
No comments.
Donna?
No comments.
Carrie?
No comments.
Fire Department, Mr. Wolf?
No comments.
Welcome.
Wait.
Need the initiation?
I know.
Now he gets to sing, right?
Yeah. Now we're going to do comments from the audience. Okay, no comments from the audience. And
make a motion to adjourn.
Seconded.
Proceed to vote.
Mr. Bentley?
Yes.
Mayor Drucker?
Yes.
Mr. Mazur?
Yes.
Mr. Newberry?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.